Okay, well, it's official. This car hates me, even after all the work I've done. It now has a water leak, antifreeze. The water pump appears to be leaking. And the only way to check that is to disassemble the entire front of the car here and check it. And in doing that, it'll need a new timing belt as well, so I guess I'm going to dig into this since I've already got so much into it. I have to get this car running again. So it leaks pretty good. You can go a couple miles and you have to refill the reservoir. So it's not something we can just live with. It's going to have to be fixed. So fortunately, the parts aren't very expensive. It's just the labor involved here. So I'm going to probably take my time. This video will probably be over, you know, a few days. So I'm going to have to get started here, start taking things apart, and just see how far I have to disassemble this to actually get to the water pump. And I also hear I'm going to need a special tool in order to hold the cams in place, so we'll see about that too. So, okay, let's get to it. Okay, well, it's out. I did not have to take the entire front of the car apart. There is room to work in here. What I did have to do is take off the coil packs. That's here. That usually sits right here. And I had to loosen the power steering pump. And the reason I had to do that is because there's some bolts right down underneath the power steering pump you have to get out. The timing belt actually is in good shape. I don't think I'm going to replace the timing belt. It actually looks really good. It was replaced just before we bought the car, and I think it still got some life left on it, so we're going to leave the timing belt in place. What I did is I marked the belt. As you can see right here, before I took it off, put a mark on the belt, a mark on each cam here, and there's one over here, and I marked it. And pulled the belt off, and then I put it back on again to be sure that everything would line back up and that I could get it back together. And it's not going to be easy, but hopefully with the belt marked and the cam gears here marked, I should be able to get everything back into position again, I'm sure hoping. But I had to take out, let's see, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 screws that hold the water pump in. And then the idler pulley there for adjusting your tension. Take that out too, because you can't get it out without getting that out of there. That goes right there. So it's out. I'll let it drain here. And a big pan down there to catch all the antifreeze. And I got to clean this up. It looks like it's been replaced before. It has a metal impeller. I guess the original ones were plastic, so this one's been replaced. And it was leaking past the seal here. I can see where it's been leaking all down through here. So it was time. Get a new one in here. Hopefully it won't take long to get it back together. It's got to get one ordered now. So like I said, this will be over a couple of days. So this took probably, I don't know, 2 hours. I went and ate dinner and came back out and finished it up. So I went real slow to make sure I wasn't missing anything. So anyways, it's easier than I thought it was going to be so far. Now that I've said that, I'm sure something horrible will happen. So okay, we'll get back to this. All right, well, it's been a couple days and the new water pump is here. Had a little snafu on the original order, and then ordered from another place, but I finally have it. This pump has the metal impeller, something I hear you want to look for, so that's what I got. So this one's ready to be tested and ready to go, so it says. So we'll have to install this thing and find out. So we're ready to go. I'm going to reinstall this and we'll see how things go. Alright, so the pump's back in. There's 9 bolts. Make sure you get them all. Go through and touch each one, make sure they're real tight. And I put the timing belt back on, and since I wasn't replacing it, I had made marks. There's one, and on the other cam here, I made another mark there. I also made one more down here just to be sure. And I put a mark here on the crank pulley as well. Made sure everything stayed lined up. I didn't actually move anything, so I got the belt back on and retensioned it. There's the tensioner right there. So now it's all retensioned. So I just have to put the covers back on and the drive belt. Oh, and also I got the power steering pumps right here. That has to be re-bolted back down. You have to remove that in order to get the bolts that are underneath out. So that's got to go back on. And then, of course, the coil packs have to go back on top of the power steering pump. So. All right, finish this up here. Okay, well, there you have it, all done. Just letting the system bleed out here. It's a closed system, so you have to get all the air out. There's also a bleeder valve, which I may have to open up if I can't get all the air out, but we'll see. So anyways, all done. Runs great, nice and smooth. So there you go. They told me at the dealership this would be about an $1,800 job, so, you know, never listen to those guys. It's never that hard. Okay, thanks for watching.